Hi folks, welcome back again. My name is Nick, and we're looking at, on the Commodore Amiga, a Tetris variant called a Blockout. This one was published by Californian Dreams in 1989. So yes, it's like Tetris, but this time it's in 3D. There's a few different modes. There's an advanced mode where the pieces are irregular, but we're going to keep this quite straightforward. Just do normal shapes on a normal grid. Now you can change the size of the grid if you want to, if you want a more difficult time. So it seems quite a basic input here, quite a basic design. Looks like it's designed on AMOS, but I don't think it is. So we'll see how this one plays. Now it's on keys. As you can see already, we're chucking the shapes down this sort of like bin thing. You can rotate it in two different directions, so it's really gonna do my brain in, right? Okay, so every time we get a line, or a level should we say, you get bonus points, and then that line will disappear. This has already tested me a great deal. We're on level 0, so the shapes go down very, very slowly, giving us time to get used to this. As you go forward in the game, it will get gradually quicker. Tetris variant. So, it's one of those games, you keep playing it, your IQ points will gradually go up, a bit like if you did a Sudoku or crosswords, because your brain is trying to work out these shapes. Right, now I'm already confusing myself. Now, on the bottom left, there's this like a bar chart you can see, just with a dark blue one down the bottom. That shows us our highest level at the moment is blue. If we put a shape in the wrong place and go up to a highest point, I think it might go a different colour. But I'm doing quite well here. As you can see, there's 6 squares I need to complete, and then we would have got equivalent to a line for bonus points, right? Right. Now, the more advanced stage I told you about before, you have irregular shapes going down, which makes it ultra tricky. There doesn't seem to be any sound on this. This did come out on the Sega Mega Drive as well, which we might come to. Maybe there's some music here. But it's not the most exciting game in the world, but it does Tetris well. And I think it's the first ever 3D Tetris variant. There we go. So we've done a level. Great. Yes. How long am I going to last on this? Now, it's a sort of game, if you start on level 0, once you get used to how to rotate it, it could be going on for ages, so I might need to edit this down. But the whole idea of this is, if you bought it as a kid, this review I mean, if you bought it as a kid, would you have gone back to play it again? I think this one would have eaten quite a lot of time without me actually realising it. I was a big fan of Tetris. I think this one could get a bit painful a bit later on, a little bit frustrating, but it is clever what it actually does. It's a bit hard to line stuff up initially, but the longer you get used to it, you get more used to rotating stuff. So it's like two angles you need to do here. If you had this one back in the day on any system, let me know. I think it came out on just about everything apart from the ZX Spectrum. It didn't come out there. Commodore 64, I think it got a release on that, and Atari ST. So it's not the most exciting game in the world to watch. Right, that's going to end up the blue. Is that a level? Come on, boom. That wasn't a level, I thought I'd done that. Right, you see on the bar on the left there, it's light blue. That's our highest level so far, so that's 3 up. If the bin fills up, then it's game over, but I should be okay. I don't know why I didn't get points that blue level. I thought I completed that. Anyway, it's on the like lightest blue level now. Bung that there. If you go wrong, it can quickly go super wrong. It can be game over very, very quickly. Yes. Come on, Nick. Where's that gonna go? I'm taking a while to get used to this on keys, really. One key rotates it left to right. Another key rotates it, about face, so to speak, a bit like that. So it's just speed. Sometimes it's a bit hard to see where the shape's going to go because it's like transparent, but it has to do that so you can see what's actually below. Okay, right. Now, if I can work out how to rotate that in the right place, that'll do. Line that up properly. There, and we just got a square left, right? Right, can I rotate this to fill that up, and then that will be a line, and we'll say yippity-doo-dah. Okay. Okay, I can't see what I'm doing now. Bung that in there. Right, boom. Boom. Good stuff. Away we go again. Now, I should be able to get the blue line here. That's why it didn't go before. I had a square missing because I put that in the wrong place. That'll go. Good, right. I'm a super duper expert. So as you can see, I should have put this on a much higher level because it's just poodling along at the moment. And you just need to get used to the shapes and you'll be playing this for absolutely ages. So maybe I should have put this on level 9. You see on the bar on the left there, it's got quite some distance where it goes to the top. So that tells you how deep your bin is. I think, as the Bee Gees once sang, how deep is your bin? I think Take That did a cover of it as well. How deep is your, how deep is, I really need to know. How deep is your bin? Sing that along at home if you want to. It might make the review go a bit quicker. Right, or I'll take that. That's free there. Don't put it in the wrong place. Countdown. 1, 2, 3. Boof. And that's just about perfect. Put that there. Should be another line. Ding, it goes again. I'm a super duper expert on this, but it does do your eyes in after a while, does it not? Let's see if I can do another line. I can quite easily see me playing this for about an hour in this game. So we might have to have extended highlights, because you don't want me gibbering and jabbering on for an hour. But anyway, if you watch this channel quite a lot, you might like me gibbering and jabbering for an hour. And you might gibber and jabber in the comment section as well. And we got a good bit of gibbering and jabbering and probably get an award on YouTube for the Jibber Jabber channel. Maybe. It could happen. Right, boom. Oh no, that wasn't a boom. That will fit there. You have to play this game really to get the idea of what's really going on. And the frustration as well. It takes a while to get used to it, he says. I did have a practice go beforehand. I was hopeless. I seem to be a little bit better this time round. It's getting used to the control mechanism. Oh, that fits quite well. Good. That will go in the top corner. That fits there quite well. Oop, don't rotate it. Or should I put it in that corner? It doesn't really matter. Right. That would go there. Filling up quite nicely here. So if you like moving shapes about the place in 3D, I think this is interesting to see, but I prefer the original Tetris there to this one. It's clever in what it's doing. It does give you an extra challenge. So Tetris fans who wanted an extra challenge could go on to this. Interesting. It's well coded. It's a nice idea. It's not the most exciting game in the world, but puzzle games don't tend to be. It's just having a bit of brain testing, getting the old green matter rotating around rather than shooting aliens and going on various rescue missions. I don't think I'm going to be able to get that in. Oh, I could do it down one, couldn't I? No, I've lined that up wrong. I meant to do it in the square next door. Okay. Yeah, it's getting a bit higher now. We're in the orange section. I think we're almost, about a third away through the bin. Bing. At least it gives me some good exciting sound. Bing. I'll have to change that to my text message noise. That'll be good. Yes, good stuff. I think I've been playing this for 2 days now. It might be time for some time later, if I haven't already done that in the editing. I might have done. Hopefully I have done. Boom. Okay, now I don't think I'll ever review every Amiga game that's ever been made, ever. We'll come to quite a lot of stinkers. Some games will be a lot more exciting than others. Sometimes there'll be time constraints and I have to try and do myself an easy one. Yes, I was time constrained this week, so I knew this game I wouldn't have to read the instructions too much. That's why I'm reviewing this one. But anyway, it's Amiga time, and this was in... it was 1989, wasn't it? So quite early in the Amiga days, and it's a curio. Let's bung that in there. I'm not quite sure what price this game was. Really only appealed to puzzle fans. Kids that just like blasting games and fighting games probably wouldn't have had much interest in this. It's the sort of game you play when you're maybe waiting for another game to load us or waste a bit of time. Right, we're starting to lose control of this now. We've got different colour sections, and the more different colour squares you've got there representing different levels you're on, the more tricky it is to try and get it back into play. I think the end of the game is imminent here. I don't know though, if I can just cover all these blue squares maybe. Well, I can't cover all the blue squares, can I? Because there's a hole underneath somewhere. So I've got to try and make it all go green, I think. I've got to take this thing and make it evergreen. That was a song as well. There's only one... Oh, God. Right, could I switch that? Bung that there. So that's going to go orange. Get rid of these blue things. Right, that's green. Bung that down there. Right. Oh, it's gone red. Right, okay, if I bung that there, is that a line? If I do that, is that a line? Green? Oh, I thought that was a line then. Obviously, there must be gaps underneath. But if I can cover those green ones up somehow, that should be a line. Yeah, if I can rotate that. Yes, that should be it. Yay, good. The magical bing noise. Excellent. If you like the magical bing noise, comment below. But also as well, I think this game could be a bit more exciting. Maybe a groovier music like Super Twin Tris did, because that's got one of the best music tracks ever on any game at all. If we had some really funky music playing, I think this game might be enhanced if you was wearing headphones and you was listening to a funky music track instead, maybe, to add the extra excitement. So yeah, try that. You might get a bit more excitement on it. It's a little bit flat in the atmosphere. A bit like the planets, well, the moon Titan, if you've ever been there. It's a methane atmosphere, so it's a little bit stinky. So if you've just been to Titan and you'll come back to Earth, have a wash, or else you'll be going places and people be smelling methane everywhere and thought maybe you've got a problem with your digestive system. Yeah, so that's a good tip. So you clicked on this to watch a review of Blockout, a Tetris variant, and what you've also got as a special bonus is a tip about methane. So well done. I'm glad that I'm teaching you and increasing your IQ, or in fact maybe lowering it. As per usual, I don't know what I'm talking about. But anyway, we're going to get a red line here. Right, that's it. Perfect shaping. Bing. Bing. Here we go. That's going to be another binger. Bing. Bing. Oh, this could be another binger. If I get that there. Yes, we're getting this back. Is that going to be another... Oh, it could be another binger here if I bunk that there. Three bingers in a row. Get that. Bing. It didn't bing. Curses. There must be something going on behind that green block. Yeah, behind the green block. Green block. Shaking Stevens there. He sung behind the green door. There was an old piano playing hot behind that. There's nothing here apart from gaps. How long can I keep playing this for? Well, you should have put it on a higher difficulty level, Nick. Well, that's my fault. Right. Oh, no. That's a boo-boo. I think that could be the boo-boo that causes the endgame hellish. Right, so I've got to concentrate on the orange level now because everything else below that is completely and utterly lost. I'm not sure what other games California Dreams did. If you know, let me know. I might have reviewed some games and just forgotten whether they just did basic games like this. Although it's like basic, but it sort of isn't basic at the same time. That was an error as well. I'm bungling that might save the day. Is that going to be a binger? No, no bingers. Yes. You might have found a better way to do this as you're watching this. It's always easier to watch. A bit like when I'm watching two people play Scrabble, I can suddenly get amazing words that they can't see, and vice versa when I'm playing, they're watching me. Probably they're a similar sort of thing. Have reviewed Scrabble on the... Have we reviewed Scrabble on the Amiga? I don't know. We've done it on one system. We've certainly done it on the Spectrum. Oh, no. Yeah, see, the higher this thing gets, the less time you've got to arrange stuff. Right. I think the end is nigh here. We're just, like, building a skyscraper city of doom. I don't know what this looked like from the side, but you can see the bar on the left is getting quite full up now. Options are running out. A bonus binger might be good here. But I need to get something down that side. Yeah, I'm doing this all wrong here. But it's good you've got different colours for each level, because without that, it would have made it absolutely impossible to try and work out. So in summary, as we're getting to the end of this, I think, It's a nice gentle game, tests the grey matter, it's different from the norm. It's not a game I would have paid full price for. It's a nice variant, but not a game I would have gone back to a great deal. But what it attempts to do, it does well. It's gone to a different area, hasn't just replicated Tetris for the sake of it. It's tried to offer something new with what was there. So I give it a thumbs up for that. Yes, hooray. Sort of. Check out Colorist, other variants, Clax as well. Super Tetris though is the best Tetris game on the Amiga for my money. Yeah, we're right at the top now. I think we've got nowhere else to put this stuff. Points are looking good, so if you do download this or track it down, try and beat my score. Good, 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 and I'm fifth on the leaderboard, which means I'm not too bad. 2019, that's me. Someone else there, 1978. Well, sorry I took so long to get to it. So, hope you liked having a look at that one. It does what it says on the tin. It's quite clever, but it's not a spectacular must-go-back-to game. So, hope you liked having a look at that one. That was Blockout on the Commodore Amiga, published by California Games in 1989. Got any comments about this game, similar games, or anything retro, then please put that below. Until next time, take great care of yourself, and a very fond goodbye.
Goodbye.